Okay.
We got some email for Pat. And this viewer writes in, I've heard that if you die while you're sinning, you'll go to hell. I'm a Christian, and sometimes I do sin, and am I in good condition for heaven?
Just imagine living under that pressure. You know, John Wesley said, there's not a day that goes by that I don't have to plead the blood of Jesus. We sin all the time. We fall short of the glory of God. We don't love Him with all of our heart as we should. Mm-hmm. There are a lot of things we do, but if we had to be fearful that if there was a breath that we took while we were not quite living up to the standards, we'd go to hell. I mean, we'd be in our lives and be in torment. The answer is, when you have come to the Lord, it's Jesus Christ today, yesterday, today, and forever. His blood is sufficient to take care of your sin. Don't live in fear that somehow you're going to wind up sinning and right after that you'll die and go to hell. That would be a horrible thing for God to inflict on anybody. Mm. All right.
Good. All right. Griselle writes, my son has contacted his estranged parent. I'm concerned because I know that the other parent smokes pot. I'm afraid the whole situation is overwhelming my son, and I think my son has a good head on his shoulders, and he fears the Lord, but I'm not sure if I should talk to the other parent without his thinking that I'm judging him. What do you think?
I don't understand exactly what you're asking me. You apparently are divorced, and you're a woman, and you've got a son living with you, and the father is into drugs, at least smokes pot. What are you asking me? I mean, you know, of course you could say, look, let's not get our children into drugs. You want them to grow up healthy and strong, and this isn't good for them. I don't know what you're saying.
Well, she says, I'm afraid the whole situation is overwhelming my son.
Yeah,
you need to talk to your son, find out how...
Talk to him. It says, should I talk to the other parent? Well, it's nice if a divorced people have, you know, dialogue, or they can be friends, and I think you could be talking to them. Of course, talk to them. All right?
Okay, this viewer writes in, Scripture talks about blessing God, and it also talks about how God blesses His people. So I wonder, will we be blessed in heaven? How will things run? I know we will be full of peace, but what about relationships? Will fellow saints, will we bless one another?
We're going to be like the angels in heaven. We will have heavenly bodies. We will be like the angels. And there will be a time where we're all just, in a sense, consumed with the glory of God. We will be surrounded with the glory of God, and there will be a bliss beyond belief. Eye hasn't seen, ear hasn't heard what God has prepared for them that love Him. So, of course, there'll be love with others. There'll be nothing but love. There won't be any hatred, jealousy, and animosity. We'll be in the presence of the Lord, and we'll be filled with life. We'll be filled with joy, but there won't be any of that other stuff. So, will we bless people as we go around? Of course, we'll be praising the Lord all the time. All right?
You know, worship is such a great foretaste of heaven,
yes.
Isn't it? When you feel the presence of the Lord.
Amen.
And you feel that. So it's
Amen.
A little down payment there. Well, Stanley has this, pride comes before a fall, but don't we need to feel good about what we do to encourage more of the same? What is the original meaning behind pride?
Well, pride is the ability that I'm better than you are, and the original pride was Satan, who said, I can do a better job than God. You know, there's a song, I did it my way. I mean, that's the ultimate. I did it my way. Mm-hmm. And Satan says, I did it my way, and I can do a better job than God. I mean, that's the origin of pride. The idea is that you have accomplished something and that you can feel satisfaction, and that you are a carpenter and you build a beautiful piece of furniture, or you build a nice house and you look at the house and say, oh, that's a wonderful house. But when you say that, you praise God. And it's so easy to say, I did it, and I ought to get credit for doing it, and I'm better than you are. And it's the idea of raising somebody above somebody else. That's the problem with pride. But accomplishment, a sense of accomplishment, is something that we all have that is a good thing.